Oh. What's happening here? Even here. How do I get all of these? Yeah. Let's go. Let's try this. Oh. Really? Okay. Where is this going to take us? No, I'm good. Let's keep going up.
Cunning one as well.
Is that Mjolnir? Did he steal Thor's hammer?
Aye, for a time.
A lot of these seem to end with Thor killing them.
Imagine that.
Yep. I think Thor is not a notorious murderer. This? There was one downstairs as well. The fortune. Okay. Fuck this. Nope. Ooh, that was intense.
Another name. Come!
Another Valkyrie. That's no coincidence. But who'd have etched them on Tyr's braziers?
Eh? Just behind. It's the Muspelheim tower. Okay. Nothing to do there. Go down now. Okay. Hello. Defense. Cool.
So Odin and Freya could have been happy, but he only wanted her magic?
Aye. A taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation and new levels of depravity.
Yep. Cool beans.
Another piece of the language cipher. Good.
That is good.
I saw something.
I saw two.
Freya did say the Jotunheim Realm Tower was missing from the lake. But maybe only kinda?
Very strange indeed.
Okay. How do I solve this puzzle? They aren't regenerating, but I still don't see the point of them. It wasn't blocking anything, so what was it doing? Okay, wait. Can't go any further down. Let's see. I mean, those permanent bonuses are real good. I really like them. Don't know what to do with that. Okay, I haven't seen any of the runes. Like any of them, which is weird. By now I would have seen at least one, right? But no, none of them. So let's jump. Oh, are they gonna light up as I light these up? That might be it. I need to pee. I need to pee now. Could have just turned the mic off, or yeah, but I didn't. Never mind. I can't do anything with that. Huh. How's this gonna work? It's a complicated puzzle. This is gonna help. No, 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 no. Don't go down. I need to find the start of the puzzle, though. Is this gonna involve a boss fight? Because this. Oh, shit. Is there supposed to be a treasure here? There is.
Look out! lucky, brother.
I hate him. Yeah, there's definitely a treasure here. The troll who killed my kin is slain, but the battle has taken its toll. I've buried whatever I have left. Watch the sunrise over the temple. I mean, I know I'm in the right place. Sort of. Okay, let's open this. Thank you. So I'm in the right place. Somewhere over the temple. This is weird. Okay. Cool. Cool, cool. Inscribed Crest of Perseverance. Okay, it's not that I don't care, but it's nothing in character. Okay. A lot of stuff around here. I do not really know where to start. Like at all. World surface scale, sure. Still go up here, don't know where this leads. Oh no, this is where I came from, okay. When did I come here? Is it just now? Am I being really dumb? Okay, never mind. So I don't know what that... What is this? What is this? Where does that lead? Nowhere, I guess. Okay. Okay. No, that was wrong. The end is not one of those. Is good then. He works. There was an R. Not 100% sure on that. Z, the R. This should be one of those. Either Z or an R. You're done with me. Is it gonna be visible from down there? No. How's it going down then? How does anyone from down there get access to that though? Shit. Oh, there's a thing here. That's all. Dumbass. Okay, I might need to return here, so I'm just gonna unlock that just to make things easier. Can I unlock that? Should be able to. No, no, go down. Actually, go down, yeah. Let's go down, just open it up. Be a nice little boy. Be a nice little Greek boy. What do I get? What? It's pretty good. Oh, perfect. Yeah. It's pretty good. Nothing major, but it's pretty good. Let's see about those.
Okay. Obviously the marriage to Odin didn't last. But how did Frey end up a hermit in the woods?
Oh, that was a singular piece of cruelty, even for Odin. As if the marriage wasn't punishment enough. Freya was better to him than he deserved. She stuck it out through all manner of indignity, all in the name of maintaining peace and safety for her people. But Odin's madness, his tyranny, his corruption of her magics, it became more than she could stomach, and at long last she broke it off. Odin's wrath was fierce, and his curses upon her were more than she dared to fear.
But her magic was so much stronger than that.
After so much time together, he knew her vulnerabilities and exploited them to craft curses she could never break.
Oh, like not being able to leave Midgard.
Worse still, he robbed her of a warrior spirit. Freya cannot fight, even to defend herself.
Okay.
No living thing may she harm by blade nor spell. In a world this belligerent, what choice does she have but isolation?
Poor Freya. I guess if I was her, I'd spit in your face too.
Aye, lad. So would I.
Make quite a formidable duo.
Yeah, that was pretty good, man. Yeah. I don't get it. That's it? Stop. Is it permanently around? Oh, it's not. That's gonna be annoying. Don't really see a solution here. I think there is a solution. Not for now.
Shrine about a giant lady with lots of books and visions.
And we'll pick this up later.
I still can't access those. Okay. Well, you're dead.
A little easier than I thought.
Yeah. Barely a good sign. Uh-huh. Okay. Yes. That is... Yeah. I think I get the gist. I hope I get the gist. Hmm. Yes. And now I'm gonna have to spin that. The real question is, why? What kind of effect will that have? Not just like that. No. There's, I need a straight piece so that I can shoot. Is there one? Oh, hello. There it is. Perfect. Thank you. And no, thank you. That's cool. I enjoyed myself. I am assuming all of this is giving experience. It's certainly giving me money and materials, which is good. Ah. Well. I had not considered this. Just as it looks. Let's try going back a bit. Okay. What's this place called? Thank you very much. Yes. Thank you. This is really good. Ah, what? What do you mean? Of 30 mystic gateways. That is not impressive at all. I'm sorry, should I just... Was I meant to just shoot that? That seemed dumb. That's why I wasn't doing it. No, I think there's a...
Mimir, there was a shrine about a giant lady with lots of books and visions.
Ah, that would be Gloa, Knowledge Keeper. She was a gifted sorceress who gathered every tome of arcane wisdom she could find in the realms, all in the hopes of augmenting her powers of prophecy that she might find her lost husband, Aurbandil. But it was not her husband she would glimpse in her visions, for it was Gloa, seeing longer and farther than any before or since, who witnessed Ragnarok. The end and the beginning. When Odin caught word of her ultimate prophecy, he maneuvered to obtain her knowledge and hoard it for himself. Gloa knew Odin as a longtime patron of her services, and so she welcomed him into her library as a friend. What she did not know is that Odin himself was behind her husband's disappearance, having used his enchantments to conceal his death at Thor's hands from her sight. Smiling, jealous Odin took her by the throat, and with his very hands he stole her library and her life for his own.
I always knew Odin was bad. But that's just...
Ruthless, barbaric, heartless? That's Odin. In fact, we would do well to sit here in silence for the next few moments and reflect on Odin's capacity for cruelty.
Cool.
And so...
Reflect longer.
I missed that. I completely missed that. I thought there was something else I was supposed to get, but no. What am I trying to accomplish here? Ah, right. No? Do I not have a boat here? I thought I did. Apparently I don't. Ah, come on. I know what I have to do, just give me the thing. Where's my boat? There's my boat. PR must be the last one. How about the sixth one? What the hell is this place? Why is it a door? This is different. Why is it different? What is that? I still have a lot of I still have a lot to see. For some reason. Also this cash, sure. Second scale, yeah. And you have a runic attack, this one. Okay, that's cool. There's a lot of variety, not a lot of upgrades. Yeah, I was going for the thingy, but never happened.
I have a question. If Ymir was the first giant, where did he come from?
In the beginning, there was Gnungagap, the Great Void. There were no realms yet, only primordial forces. There was fire, and there was ice. And there in the Void, they met and produced...
Okay. Is that it? I think it is.
These bones pulse with magic.
It must be Golvi. Could we just hold on to it? Maybe we'll find the rest of them.
Your spirit lies to you, boy.
How would you know?
I have known many spirits. They are all liars.
This one is different. I know it.
You know very little.
This is a fight, right? I really don't like
you. You are one vicious son of a bitch.
Oh, yeah, this is.
Trusting a spirit to keep its word is foolish, boy.
But if there's even a chance, don't you want to see Mom again?
Of course I. She is gone, Atreus. You must accept this.
I do, but to see her again, just one more time.
Why do you believe him? You do not know him or who he was. All of this is sinister.
He wants to see someone he loved again. I understand how that feels. I don't think there's anything sinister about it.
Hope is blinding your instincts, boy.
Where can I?
Right there. We were in the middle of a story, weren't we? Regarding Ymir. Primordial fire and ice met in the Great Void, producing water.
Water?
More than water. The mystic lifeblood of something entirely new. From this water, Ymir took form and became a being of pure creation and chaos, mother and father to all that came after.
Even the Aesir?
Aye. Every god, man, and beast came first from Ymir's flesh. Though it was the Aesir who thought themselves so superior that they should hold dominion over the rest of creation. It was Odin who took arms against his creator and spilled Ymir's lifeblood with his spear. A necessary evil, he would say, to bring order to the realms. Ymir's torn flesh, Odin would fashion the realm of Midgard for his own. Called himself All-Father, as if he was the creator and not the creator's destroyer. A small, covetous tyrant.
Ymir?
Huh? Oh, sorry, my boy. You know, I think it best we just end it there, actually.
Okay.
Wow. It's like there was an entire city under the water.
Aye, lad. A forgotten city.
What was it called?
Well, I forgot.
Ancient, nice.
One more and we can translate those Niflheim runes.
Cool. Making some progress. That's good.
Govi's bones.
What will you say to her?
To Govi?
Your mother. What have you left unsaid?
I just want to know if she's okay.
She is dead, boy.
I know that. You don't understand.
Neither do you.
He's a good dad, man.
Lemire, why don't you tell us the story of the giant that stole Thor's hammer?
Happily, my boy. It involves your friend Freya, too, though I don't expect it's one she'd enjoy being reminded of. The giant was called Thrym, and he proved cunning enough to make off with Mjolnir while the Thunder Lummox slept. Sadly for Thrym, he didn't always think with his brain. Though he had robbed the greatest giant killer of his greatest weapon, he offered to trade it back to the Aesir in exchange for Freya as his bride.
Dumbass.
Now, at this point, Freya was married to Odin, and Odin, frankly, would have traded her for a sufficiently strong mead, but he saw an opportunity here. Thrym's palace was in Jotunheim, and only giants know the way. By agreeing to the marriage, they'd have to escort Freya back to their realm. So, Odin coerced Freya into using her Saethir magics to conceal Thor, so he could sneak along with her and infiltrate Jotunheim. When the hammer was produced as the wedding dowry, Thor revealed himself. He took back Mjolnir and wasted no time in smashing Thrym's skull, followed by every other giant present for the festivities. The only thing that put a stop to it was Freya, who wanted no part of this massacre. She cast a powerful spell that hurtled them both out of Jotunheim with no means of return. Odin was livid, hoping that Thor's foothold in Jotunheim would become his own. And oh, would he ever revenge himself upon Freya?
What is the point of this story, Head?
Well, for Thrym, the lesson would be to keep his priorities straight. For Freya, it's that doing good has a price. For Thor, it's that no object of power makes you what you are. And if what you are is the biggest butchering bastard in the Nine Realms, nobody can take that away from you.
Yeah.
What would you say to Mom?
Nothing.
Nothing?
There is nothing left to say.
What about everything we've done so far? That man coming to the house? Talking to the world serpent? We've done so many amazing things. I just want to tell her about them. Don't you?
What else would you say to her?
I'd tell her that we're both okay.
Both
not to worry about us.
Thrym.
Atreus, I...
Eric.
I miss her too. You know this.
I thought I knew very little.
Thank you, Dick.
Are you okay?
No, son. My goods are underwater. My men are drowned, and yet their bodies continue to walk the beaches.
Hellwalkers. They plague these lands.
I was their captain. They died because of me. But these abominations sully their memories. I will find a way to free them from their tortured state. In this, I am determined.
I'm finding a lot of horror. Guess I couldn't use them, not use them all. That's dumb. Skull.
The final bone.
Yeah.
We might as well return them to the spirit. Maybe he will keep his word.
I know she's not coming back, okay? I know. I just... Never mind.
Forget it, kid.
I just gotta return the bones.
Forget it, kid. I get it. Nobody likes if she's dead. I hate these guys. I hate these guys so much. I hate these guys so much. I hate them so much. I hate them so much. How are they a thing? Wolves are terrible. If I do that, I'm gonna hit it again. Whatever that is, there it goes.
I discovered opportunities for hunting and trade in these lands. I gave up my search for Jotunheim long ago. Leave that for the younger, more hopeful men.
Okay.
But I was overeager.
I wonder why Bilby's bones are all over the place.
Desecration, typically. Pieces of scattered corpse make for a piss-poor soul. No hope for Valhalla or Helheim when your arm's on one beach and your head's on another.
Why not ask the spirit? I'm sure he will be forthcoming with answers.
Okay. You don't have to say it that way. Come on. Now you're just being mean.
Ed, you are full of stories. When will you tell one that entertains?
I beg your pardon?
He just insulted you.
Yeah, I got that. So you want a corker, do you? Very well, my brothers. I'll tell you the story of Brunia and Brawler. The real story.
There was a huge battle, right? His shrine had him in the middle, fighting off Aesir.
A pretty story, but no. Brunia, you see, was born with neither head nor heart. So the giants had to complete him with stone. He was strong, to be sure, but also a perfect simpleton. Odin met him wandering in Midgard one day. Found him so amusing, so harmless, so gullible, that he invites him back to his palace in Asgard. There he gives Hrungnir his fill of mead, and goads him into all manner of boasts and antics, all for the amusement of the court. I was there. I saw the Aesir laugh as Hrungnir leapt upon his shield and swore he'd kill us all and take our womenfolk back to Jotunheim. Then Thor shows up. And does he laugh? Oh, no. Thor takes one look at the drunken stone buffoon and brings down Mjolnir on his head so hard that he's got chunks of Hrungnir in his own skull to this day. Thor is so startled by the faceful of rock, he doesn't notice Hrungnir's body topple right onto him with a sickening crunch. And again, the roars of laughter echo through the palace halls.
That's an awful story, Mimir. Nothing like the ones Mother told me.
Let that be a lesson, my son. Truth is seldom so pretty as myth and legend.
Collected the rest of your woman's corpse spirit. Show us this magic you have promised.
Ah, oh, my sweet Gulvig. Whole again.
It's gonna be a buzzer.
Rise, dear Gulvig. Awaken, oh powerful Gulvig!
Yep.
Edni Ukabithiast.
She says she'll honor our request.
Eldi Fagna.
And reunite us?
In Dow the Tea!
Okay, you're up. I told you so.
You are naive, foolish boy.
This is true as well. But do not take your disappointment out on me, boy. Take it as a lesson.
Yes, sir.
Oh.
Mimir, is there a story for the giant with the flaming sword?
Surt the Brave. Of course. We've spoken so much of frost giants. It's about time we instead met the most fiery giant of all. Back when Ymir first emerged from Ginnungagap, it was Surt who followed next. He came from Muspelheim, the Fire Realm, bringing heat to the young cosmos, conjuring the sun from his primordial flame. But let's come back to that flaming sword, shall we? Surt the Brave forged his sword of flame for one purpose alone. To burn down Asgard when Ragnarok comes at last. His destiny is to fall in the hands of Thor and Odin, but in so doing, strike the blow that leaves their realm in ash and ruin. And from that destruction, the world can be born anew. Until then, alone he waits in Muspelheim, never sleeping, ever honing his fiery blade. Brave, generous sword, who knows he lives but to his doom. All because he chooses to serve a grand cycle, so much bigger than himself. To truly embrace your purpose and the patience and sacrifice it demands is to ensure your day will come.
You think we'll be there when that day comes?
I've seen enough of war between the gods, but you, little brother, who can say?
What's that down there?
What is this place? Cool. What is this place though? There's a lot of stuff here. I don't think I've seen any of it. Yeah. Another couple of bonuses. Yeah, these side quests are gonna be pretty important. How do I go farther?
Be ready.
Look out behind you!
those guys part of his crew? That's a tough crew.
And all were his responsibility.
That's a lot of responsibility.
Does it frighten you?
Responsibility.
No. I don't think so. I mean, I think it used to, but not as much anymore.
Why is that?
Well, being out here, with you, makes me feel more grown up.
That's sweet. This is sweet, man. You're a good kid, man. You're a good kid, man. Mate. What? What's this even taking us? Have I been here before? I don't think so. I don't remember this place. Yeah, it's an elevator. Yeah, can we maybe?
Maybe I can fly.
No, no! Gods too must stay on the path, I promise you.
Okay. Tell me again how Odin knew we were going to Jotunheim before we did.
Odin is extremely clever, you see. Nearly as clever as he thinks he is. And he's a collector of prophecies. If it's about the future, he adds it to his collection. Helps him style himself as all-seeing and all-knowing. But of course, the idea is control. Control of the future, control of his fate. He'd control every realm of every land in every world if he could. Every potential pocket of resistance, he seeks to eliminate. Even if you've never posed a threat before, he may think one day you might. So you see, it's not important how he knew before you did. It's important that he was right.
Mm-hmm. This is a lot of stuff.